So, PC, always nice to sit and chat.
Yep.
Let me ask you, as we look back on this year, 2015, there were lots of presentations at ESHRAE and here at ASRM and other conferences.
Yes.
What strikes you as having been the most important and impactful advances this year?
Yeah, I think there are several impactful developments. One is the greater emphasis now on the elective single embryo transfer. Two is on the area of time-lapse morphokinetics assessment. And also we begin to hear a little bit more on PGS, pre-implantation genetic screening, and a wider application on the role of anti-Mullerian hormone. So I think these are about the three or four areas that we hear quite a bit of in 2015.
So there were lots of advances at the maternal side and on the embryo side. And you know, when I think about time lapse and I think about PGS, I think about really working on selecting the right embryo, and that works towards selective single embryo transfer.
Right.
And the AMH on the maternal side. So I think there's really, we have a bright future coming up.
Yes.
Does anything else strike you as what you heard about this year? Any presentations that were really
Yes,
out
I think
of the park?
Beginning to hear a little bit more, and maybe then probably leads to next year. I think even more on the maternal side is on the endometrial receptivity. So I think identifying biomarkers which may help to select now the timing, proper, better timing for embryo transfer.
So now we're looking at that personalized medicine in fertility, right?
Yeah.
And it's funny, I was chatting with somebody earlier, it's sort of like personalized at the mother and personalized at the embryo.
That's right. Selecting the best embryo and selecting the best time to transfer. I think that would be what we're going to hear increasingly more of.
And now looking at 2016 and the future, what do you hope to see coming out in research, in available techniques and technologies for the lab or the clinic?
I would say it's more going to be a bit more personalized. More personalized in terms of individualization of stage stimulation, then continuing the emphasis on selecting the best embryo and therefore selecting the best single embryo transfer to the best environment. Again, uterine receptivity assays. So I think we're going to see more refinement of these areas.
So personalization, refinement, I think we're in a good place. And so when you look back to when you started in
right.
this field,
yes,
it's completely different.
Oh, yes.
So could you have ever predicted, if I would have asked you 15 years ago, single embryo transfer
right.
and testing of the embryos?
Yes.
Would you have ever thought that was possible?
I don't think so. I think we have come a long way. And I think looking back 15, 20 years ago, I didn't imagine we would have come this far.
Well, always good to talk to you. And maybe when we sit together again next year, we'll say your predictions were right.
Yeah, thanks, Lawrence. Always good to see you.